It's Mark Wiens here. I am in Yangon, Myanmar, and I am at one of the most famous local restaurants in the entire city called Feel Myanmar restaurant. And this place is like a gigantic Burmese food institution. This restaurant is almost like a network chain of a restaurant. There's like different stations selling different things. A station over there selling duck. No idea what they're making over here. Oh, dim sum. Serving dim sum over here. And then there's even like a random gelato stand right in the middle. There's multiple dining rooms. We luckily got a seat outside, but it just finished raining. The main section that I went to order all the food is the Burmese curry house, which is sort of on the left-hand side of the restaurant. That was one of the most amazing food curry buffets that I think I've ever seen in my life.
Mutton curry?
Yeah.
Yeah, one.
This one.
Say no.
Fish curry?
Then butter fish.
Yeah, can I have that one?
Yes.
Okay, this.
I have to admit that I went a little bit crazy and ordered a bunch of different dishes. I'm gonna start with this little shrimp curry. You can just chew right through the shell. They're a little bit sweet and also nicely spicy. Chilies. I think there might be like some turmeric in there. I don't really know what exactly it is, but it is, I believe it's stuffed with fish. That's what my waiter told me, so. Oh yeah, that's like meaty on the inside. Maybe it's like a fish cake that is like steamed and wrapped in a leaf. Has a good fresh flavor to it. But then that fish is nicely spiced as well. And it has a really good texture. It's not rubbery, but kind of firm, but minced at the same time. Okay, next up is a goat curry, which I am extremely excited for. Goat is one of my favorite meats. Oh, this looks just rich, rich and marvelous. Okay, oh, that looks tender. Oh yes, I'm gonna add a little more sauce to it. Oh, I cannot wait. Oh man, that is my style of a curry. Oh, the goat is beautifully tender, and then that sauce, it's a little bit sour. But I can just taste that undertone, that rich blend of spices. And then it is a little bit oily, but it's not too oily like some other curries that I've had before. That's just fantastic. I love this little side dish of chilies and garlic. I think I might have to add one of each to a bite of the goat to even elevate it to even more incredible levels. Oh. Oh man, I really love you. Oh man. This one is a pork curry, and it definitely looks on the oily side, but wow. This looks like some shallots and pork, and it looks very greasy indeed. Wow. That pork is unbelievably tender. That just completely fell apart in my mouth. And then with that stewed shallot, or maybe it was a white onion, that just brought out the fragrance. It's cooked quite plain, but I think it's just the texture of that pork that makes it so good. This one is another fish curry, and there's a pretty thick layer of oil, but it does look awesome as well. Fish out a chunk with some of the gravy. It's not quite as flavorful as the goat curry, but the fish is excellent. I think he said this was butterfish. So that's like, the fish is really almost creamy, but yet it still has some texture to it. You can really taste the flavor of coriander, cilantro in there. I pointed to a few different salads, so I got a couple of different salads to try as well. I'm not sure exactly what this vegetable is, but it looks like there's some crispy shallots and some tomatoes mixed in. Oh. Mmm. That is like, it's almost nutty in flavor. It almost tastes like spinach. So it's like a rich green leaf. There are lots of onions in there. I can taste the tomatoes. And then those crispy shallots just, of course, bring out an amazing fragrance throughout the whole bite. And then finally, this one is an eggplant salad, I believe. And it looks like there's a bunch of onions and cilantro in there as well. That's just kind of a plain eggplant salad, but maybe it's seasoned with a little bit of oil and all these onions and cilantro. But we actually didn't even order this, but the kind waiter just delivered it to us, a bowl of mohinga, which is of course one of the national most popular dishes in Myanmar. Mm. Oh yeah. That's a very good bowl of mohinga. And finally, this entire meal has been supplemented with a beautiful plate of boiled vegetables and a chili dipping sauce in the middle, little eggplant. Oh yeah. Mmm. It tastes like shrimp paste and chilies and maybe some roasted fish or something like that. Makes the meal complete and kind of brings all the flavors together. I'm a huge fan of any kind of vegetables and also chili dipping sauces. Yeah, all of the dishes were wonderful, but I really especially loved that goat curry. And what else was awesome? Actually, that pork. I think this is a definite restaurant to keep on your must-eat-at list. I just want to say a huge thank you to all of my YouTube video supporters from Myanmar. Thank you so much for all of your food suggestions here. I want to dedicate this video to you, and many of you recommended this restaurant, so I had an awesome time eating here. I went a little crazy. I'll admit that I went a little crazy at the buffet curry line. I could not resist. That's definitely an impressive display of curries. But anyway, thank you all for all of your food suggestions. And yeah, I really appreciate it. I'm having a sweat attack right now. The air is so humid right now because it just rained. And it looks like it might rain again soon. But also, my body is seriously digesting. Wow, this is an awesome meal. Oh man, got to stretch a bit. Push down the food a bit. This was our server. Very good.